going to play for you now, Rainbow Fish. Rainbow Fish is in my collection called the Beanbag Zoo Collector Series. And all of the pieces in this collection are based on characters that are made from beanbag animals that are made with this sort of, they have the really nice, soft, fluffy velour covers. And my daughter collected those little stuffed animals when she was a young child and absolutely loved all of her beanbag collection. And she also loved a book called Rainbow Fish, which was just a beautiful story. And so all of these pieces were inspired by the way when we play with our toys and play with our stuffed animals, that we kind of make up our own stories. And so this is a musical story. And I'm going to play it for you now. So here is Rainbow Fish. So I put an instruction at the end of the piece that there's a fermata sign. And so I'm sure that many of you know a fermata sign means that you're supposed to hold the note value longer. And it sort of stretch it to where it feels like it's sounding good. And what I wrote there was hold the fermata until the sound fades. So I want student performers to kind of get in the habit of listening all the way to the end of their piece. You know, so much when we finish a piece, we want to like finish up and play our end, like, I'm done, and take a bow. But no, I would like you to really listen. So it's sort of like being an actor. So while you're on stage, you have to be in the character. So when you're in the piece, you have to be in the piece right to the very end. And here's a couple cool things that I love about this piece is it teaches you about a special scale called a whole tone scale. And that means there's no half steps. And so you can talk about that with your teacher, but so that makes a really, really cool sound. And when you combine it with pedal, then it just sort of has this beautiful resonance and all the notes go together beautifully with just one pedal. So you get to really experience the wonderful sound of piano when the pedal is held and you get to hold that one pedal through the whole piece. So you don't have to learn a lot about changing the pedal, but it gives you that experience of hearing that sound. And there were composers in this era of music called Impressionism that had a couple main composers like Debussy and Ravel who really loved to use whole tone scales, and they used them often, particularly in pieces that depicted water and flowing water and using a lot of pedal. So it's really a fun thing for you when you're experiencing a piece at this level that you get to play pedal through the whole piece and experience a whole tone scale. So I hope that you'll enjoy. Holding that whole tone scale. I hope you will enjoy this piece. Thank you.